Hey, Fit with Friends. Hope you are having an amazing Memorial Day weekend and taking a moment to really think about why we celebrate this holiday and be very thankful and mindful of all of those who serve, but especially those who gave all so that we can enjoy the freedoms that we enjoy in this great country. I'm so very thankful for every serviceman and woman that has fought so that I have the right to do the things that I do daily. So I hope that you take a moment and just kind of think about that. But today, we're gonna work on our upper body strength, particularly our shoulders and chest and back. So like when I say upper, I mean upper. We're not gonna do much buys and tries, but we're gonna incorporate some cardio in with it as well. So go ahead and set your trackers for HIIT because we are gonna be moving. And I'll have you in and out. And again, I'm sorry this is coming later in the day instead of early in the morning. I just didn't get it done in time. So anyway, let's get started. Get your music going. We're about 32 minutes of work here today. We're taking 40 seconds on, 20 seconds off two times. So at 32 and 1, let's march it out. I hope y'all have had a chance to enjoy some sunshine, some vitamin D. It's always so good for my soul. I just feel better when I get to be in the sun when I'm beside the water. I don't want to be like out in the sun just walking around, but if I'm in the water or by the water lounging, it just springs me life. Pump your arms, loosen up those shoulders. Keep marching. Take this up just a little to a boxer shuffle or a baby jog. Keep those arms going. Chest up tall. Big inhale and exhale. Just gonna wrap your mind around what we're gonna do for the next 30 minutes. It's all for you and your health and your well-being, mental and physical. All right. Let's do planted feet in 3, 2, 1. Arm circles backwards, big and wide and slow and exaggerated. Open that chest. Let's do one more this direction. Pause and reverse. Same thing, big, wide. Pull those shoulder blades apart. Exaggerate the motions. One more this direction. All right, arms cross back and forth in the front. Open chest. So when you cross in the front, palms are down. When you open to the side, thumbs come up. Try to switch which hand is on top. All right, relax. One single arm circles. Other side to the back. One more. Now, step knee up to booty. I'm sorry, not knee, ankle to booty. Stretch front of those legs. Knee up in front. Keep those arms moving. Okay. Think we're warm. If we're not, take a few more seconds and do what you need to do. I didn't tell you what weights I had today. I had some babies. Had my threes. If I had some twos here, I'd probably pull them out. Don't even know if I'm going to use them, but there's an opportunity to use them. I have 12s. I should grab 10s. I didn't. I have 115 and 120. So something in the medium range, maybe a little heavy, and then super light. The first move we're gonna do is sumo squats, and we're gonna take a weight and either hold it our chest or put it on your traps over your shoulders in the back. Or you can hold it above head. So pick what you want to do, and I'm going to go a little bit heavier for this move. So sumo squats, feet are wide, toes are angled out, chest up, shoulder blades down, drop that booty now. So we'll drop, squeeze at the top. You gotta keep a tall spine, push that pelvis forward, use your glutes to pull yourself up, keep that core in tight. Just regular pace here, up and down. We'll change it on the second round. And again, this weight can be at your chest. It can be over your head as long as it doesn't make you lean forward or backward and have a crooked spine. Or you can set it behind your shoulders. Ready? Rest. Okay, so for the second set, we're going to pulse for the first 20. And then we will static hold for the second 20 with alternating heel raises. Are we ready? 3, 2, 1. So we're gonna pulse. Don't come out of this squat. Drop that booty. Keep squeezing. You may have to adjust. Chest is tall. Belly is in. I feel that. Dig those feet in. Especially in the heels, pelvis tucked under, hand, pause, lift heel, switch, lift heel, switch. Just back and forth, and incorporate a little calf muscle here. And keep that belly in, we're almost there. 3, 2, and 1, good. Next move, kettlebell swings. I'm gonna go down, I think, to my 15, and remember, there are two ways to do this. You can either do straight legs, flat back, push booty backwards, or flat back, bent knee, okay? Your momentum will help you swing down and up, but your hips, booty, and hamstrings are doing the work. So lift and lower. Push up with this, with the pelvis. That's where your power is coming from. Dig into those feet. Whichever version you're doing, push that booty back. Pause at the top. Squeeze booty. Be sure you're not feeling this in your lower back. If you are, you need to make an adjustment. 3, 2, and 1. All right. I like kettlebell swings. And I actually do have a kettlebell, but it's not necessary. You can use a dumbbell, but if you have a kettlebell, get after it. Whatever equipment you need works for you. And here we go. Second set. So pause at the top, squeeze glutes, slam down, pausing at the top. I'm trying to get my hands right today. Keep that belly in when you bend over. Weight goes in those heels, but your toes need to be touching the floor too. Push the booty back. And again, if you like the bent knee version, that's good. Do it whatever works for you. I find that I strain my low back a little more doing it that way. And rest. Whew, I'm running out of breath. All right, next move. You can take it up or down, but some version of lunges. So you can either step out, tap the floor, or alternate legs. You can do baby switches, or you can pull out switch, okay? So three versions. Go from low impact to high impact. Ready? Let's go. And I'm probably going to switch it up. If you're going down, just step in lunges. Step with the heel. Keep your spine tall. Try to make your knee kiss the floor, but not slam into it. Now I'm going to go switch, switch. You can add weight here. Holding it if you need to. can hold it down to the side or at your chest. 3, 2, 1. All right. So, multiple versions. Find what works for you. Push without harming your body. Okay? Catch your breath. Deep breath. Good breath here. Jump lunges or lunge steps or lunge hops. Ready? Another option. Staying on one leg in a lunge. Hop it up. Knee shouldn't dart out over your foot. I'm staying on one leg. And I'm going to switch. In 3, 2, 1. Now I'm switching. So these are pulse lunges with a hop. Little hop. Use that back leg. Weight pushing up out of that front heel. 3, 2, 1. Ah, whose legs are running? I say it was upper body, but remember, we're going to incorporate lower so that our heart rate goes up. Wood choppers, okay? So, pick your weight. The motion is going to be feet are wide. You're going to twist to the side. Your hip twists towards you with your arms. Come across in the front. Little squat. Okay, so up, squat. Ready? Let's go. Up, squat. Try to control it. Chop across. Or kind of like a weird baseball or golf swing maybe too. Core in tight. My weight's too heavy. I can't feel bad form. Let me switch. Here we go. There we go. Use that core. Twist and turn. 3, 2, 1. Yep, I had really bad form. My weight was too heavy. So, please make adjustments. Maybe your weight is too light. If that is true and you don't have anything heavy, squeeze and contract. Ready? Opposite side. Here we go. Come across and up. Pivot on the balls of those feet. You've got control of the weight with your shoulders at the top. Your core is engaged when you bring it down. Twist and turn. Chop across. Don't let it swing out of control. Try to stop it. Set a point in front of you. Stop. You're almost there. 3, 2, 1. Good job. All right, square hops. We have not done these in a little hot minute. So, you're going to hop front, side, back, side, front. You're going to make a box. So, you can step it. If you don't want impact, don't let your feet get all tangled up. Or you can full out hop. Front, side, back, side, front. Ready? Hop or step. Make a box. You can add your arms if you want. It's a lot to think about at one time. Hold them up here. You can add weight. Keep that box tight. Use every part of your leg in this hop. Core tight, tight. Shoulders up. The blades are down and back. 3, 2, 1. All right, so second time, we'll do exactly whatever you did the first time, opposite direction. So you can step it. If you're just gonna do the steps, add some weight. Here we go, big breath. 3, 2, hop to the right. Belly in. Tall spine. Breathe.
Move that wonderful body God gave you. Whew, already sweating. Whew, keep going. Don't quit. Step it out if you have to. You're close. Almost there, guys. 3, 2, 1. Yes. Awesome job. Down to the mat for bridge with a chest fly. Now, I may have to go down to my babies because I don't know if I can do 12s, but we'll see. So, chest fly, arms come open, squeeze right over your chest. Don't let the weight be over your belly button or your head. They come together in the middle and you squeeze. So, lift up to bridge, squeeze those glutes, weights start at the top, open and close, squeeze the booty. And if you want to drop down and just worry about chest, then drop down and just do chest. The glute bridge makes you incorporate those lower muscles. Remember, you're holding some money back there if you're in the glute bridge. Don't let it go. Tuck it under. Don't just lift your low back. 3, 2, 1. Whew. Alrighty. I'm gonna go down. Use my small weights and really squeeze in my chest and think about how those muscles are working. Set up. 3, 2. If you're lifting, lift. 1, really squeeze. And even though now I'm using 3s instead of 12s, I feel it more because I have more control over these light weights. And I am intentionally contracting over my chest and out open. Tuck that pelvis under. Hold that $100 bill. Squeeze. You've got it. Almost there. You can do this. 3, 2, and 1. Awesome. Okay. We're coming back up for jump ropes. We will come back to the mat after that. Whew. So, for jump ropes, you've got options. Hop, just regular hop. You can kick out. You can hop big. Whatever works for you. You can side to side. If you want to add weights, add weights. But whatever you're doing, move those arms with it. Ready? They're moving that rope for you, right? Chest out. Shoulders pulled back. Find your jump rope. I wasn't very good at jump rope when I was a kid. I'm really not good at it now, probably. But, something I can work on. Feel this in your chest, in your biceps, as you're moving that rope. 3, 2, 1. All right. If you want to add weight, add weight. If you want to lose weight. I just did what I did there. Drop weight. All right. Breathe. Jump ropes. Last set. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Laying with soft knees. Don't lock them out. You need to change it. There's lots of ways you can do this. Kind of like a kick out. Pull that shoulder blade down in the back. You're close. Going this way. 3, 2, and 1. All right, we are back to the mat for bridge with a chest press. All right, now I'm going to use a single weight This time I grabbed a 20, and I'm going to press up and pull down. If you would rather use two weights, come out to 90 degrees, push up, squeeze at the top, come back down, shoulder and elbow in line, elbow and wrist in line. Ready? Lift, bridge, chest has to stay contracted, every pull and push. And lower that glute bridge if you'd like, or you can lift it with each press. You need to add a layer. Keep the weight over the chest, especially if you're using single. Squeeze those cheeks. 3, 2, 1. Good job. We got another set of that. We are chipping away at this. Moving right along. So you have your day to enjoy, or you'll be done with your day and you can go to bed. Ready? 3, 2, 1. I'm going to pulse my bridge and squeeze and push and pull my chest. Now don't get so wrapped up in the pulse that you forget what we're working here, which is chest. If you need to hold static, hold static, or drop down. Really think about that. Don't let your forearms do the work. Your chest pushes up. Your hands are just there for support. Here we are, last one. 3, 2, and 1. All right. Next move. High knee twist. Okay. So, you know what high knees are, and you know what a twist is. So the top half is going back and forth. Right here at the waist, you're twisting while you lift your knees. So you'll twist with opposite knee. If you want to step, step jump, that's a great option. You can also add a weight here. If you're jumping, keep those shoulders back. You're in a little bit of a lean back. This has got to be tight in the center. Elbows and arms in close. Don't let them fly. Belly's in. Breathe. Keep that chest up tall. Don't slouch and round your back. Three, two, one. All right. I think I'll add a weight this time, which means for me, I'm not going to be able to go as fast. So you do what works for you. If you would rather have the speed and the cardio, don't maybe add a weight or add a very light weight. 3, 2, 1. See, I have to go slower so I can control the weight. Still using my core, my obliques. Knee is lifting. Belly's tight. Chest turns with the weight. Breathe. Almost there. 3, 2, 1. I get way more out of breath than that version. Next move to the mat. On Supermans. Now, this is where, if you choose, you can add light weights in your hands as you fly out. One or two. So come on down slowly. Now we're almost done. We've got under 10 minutes left. For Superman, versions can vary. If you would like, you can lift that weight. You can lift two weights. You are going to squeeze that booty as tight as you ever have, no matter what you're doing. You can lift just the top half or only the bottom half. Keep your head in line with your neck. Ready? Lift. Line through the air and lower. Up squeeze, down pause. When you come down, it gives you a chance to reset, to contract even tighter. Keep your belly in, even though it's on the floor. Pull it into your back. Exhale on the lift. Almost there. Three, two, and one. You should feel that from the top, the back of your shoulders, all the way down into your calves even, your Achilles tendon. If you want to do no weight, just come up and down. Another option is weights right here at the side and lift. Ready? Begin. So elbows in and lift to the side. You're going to pull those shoulder blades back toward your spine. Wrap around it. We're doing it this way. Even if you don't have weights, same thing. You can also up, out, up, out with no touch. Squeeze. Almost there. Three, two, one. All right, we're coming back up. We've got speed skaters. Woo, I'm not very graceful in my up today. All right, so for speed skaters, we're skating down like we're on the ice. You've seen speed skating, right? They push back with their feet. You don't have to have a weight. I'm gonna do a weight just to add a little resistance. If you need to step, just tap back. When you do, do a little crunch to each side. Core in tight. Ball up. Keep that core in. Try to hollow out that belly. You can do weights this way too. This really gives you some extra shoulder. Oh yes. Work those legs. Work those arms, weights or not. Speed skating down the ice. Three, two, one. All right, so I'm getting rid of the weights. And I'm really going to get some speed. This is your last set of cardio, I think. Yeah, so see if you can give it 100. I know you're tired. Dig in. All right, dig in. You got this. Ready? Big breath. Three, two, one. Get it. Fast. Or add your weights and be controlled. And again, step if you don't want the impact. Go with power. Belly in. Don't forget to breathe. You guys are amazing. Dig in. You can do this. Tell yourself, you can do this. And you'll do it. You got it. Three, two, one. Good job. Last move. Swimmers. Who's going to the pool? Or who went to the pool? It's that time. So, let's get on down in the pool. Swim out for our last exercise. So, opposite arm and leg. Lift and lower. Ready? Head in line with neck. Three, two, one. Take your time. Keep that booty, hamstring, quad contracted. Don't let your shoulders come up high around your neck. Act like you're trying to tuck your shoulder blades in your back pockets. Crown of your head should be forward. Strain your neck. Keep swimming. Three, two, one. Last 40 seconds. Here it comes. We can do this. We got this. Yes, we do. Okay, we're going to go a little faster this round. For the first half, for sure. Ready? Breath in, out. Three, two, one. We got to swim fast. Like, what if I bust it out? Baby shark, do-do-do-do-do. You know, there are workouts to that song. That's for you, Cassie. Swim, swim, swim. Paddle, paddle, paddle. All right, we're going to change it to a breaststroke. Ready? Three, two, one. Feet stay. Push that water away. Chest is up tall. Head in line with your neck. Elbows out and in. Swim, swim, swim. Ooh, those legs all feel like they're cramping. Three, two, one. Yes. Oh, good job. All right. Push back into child's pose. Big breath in. Booty up. Knees wide. Sit back on those feet. Reach far away from your feet with your fingertips. And breathe. Just take a minute to acknowledge the hard work you just did. Relax. All right. We're going to come forward. Down into your belly. Slower, slowly lower down. Put hands right beside shoulders. Or you can go to your forearms, but we're going to push up to cobra. Ready? Three, two, inhale. One, exhale. Push and lift. Try to really stretch. Pull that chin up if that's too much on your back. Come down to your forearms. We don't want you to really pull that chin up. Feel it in your neck. All right, release. We're going again, and this time chin goes to your chest. So we're going to stretch the back of the neck. Ready? Inhale. Exhale. Fold your head forward. Drop that head. Feel it in the back of your neck. Push back. Child's pose one more time. Exhale. Come to all fours. Stretch. Opposite arm and leg out. Push back into the heel of the straight leg. Push away with the palm of the front arm. Try to pull that heel as far away from your fingers as you can. Feel it in the back of that calf. We'll get some hops. Put that belly in. Release. Let's switch sides. Opposite hand, opposite foot. Oh, that feels so good. Push. Belly stays tight. Breathe and relax. Release. All right, come to Indian style or sitting on your knees, whichever is better for you. We're going to stretch our shoulders out. So arm open, comes across your chest. Pull and look over that shoulder. Relax this shoulder and let your hand or arm that's pulling do all the work. Really feel that shoulder stretch out. One more pull. Switch sides. Spine as tall as you can, whether you're sitting Indian style or on your knees. Hump your chest up, spine straight. Arms back up to center, opposite side. Drop, chest up, spine is straight. Okay, I hope good burn. I'm a sweaty mess. I think I have mascara down to my nose. My Shari's drinks, you can't really tell because the way it's made. But we did it. So, hope to see you soon. Hope your weekend's great. I miss y'all, and I'm hoping to get to see you in person soon. Take care.